announcing the arrival of Yang Berbahagia, Dr. Chong Chi Kiong, Director of Disease Control Division, Ministry of Health Malaysia, representing Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri Dr. S. Subramaniam, Minister of Health Malaysia. And Yang Berbahagia Prof. Datuk Dr. Mat Nasir Shamsuddin, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic and International, University Putra Malaysia, accompanied by Yang Berbahagia Prof. Datuk Dr. Abdul Jalil Nordin, Dean, Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences, University Putra Malaysia. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the National Anthem of Malaysia, Negaraku dan Putra Gemilang.
Thank you.
Thank you. You may now be seated. Selamat datang.
Ahlan wa sahlan.
Huanin guanlin.
Svagat hain.
Khos amniyatid.
Eku abu.
Shagotum.
Mabuhay.
Yende tonrap.
Haun genin.
Welcome. Welcome to the ICEOH 2016 Malaysia.
As customary, we start with a Malaysian welcoming poetry. Sirih berlipat, sirih pinang, sirih dari Pulau Mutiara. Pemanis kata, selamat datang. Awal bismillah, pembuka bicara.
I will reply in English. I welcome this day with all of you today to a country full of charms and beating drums. Selamat datang to Malaysia, as we say, a place where you always will be welcome with open arms.
Yang berbahagia, Dr. Chong Chi Kiong, Director of Disease Control Division, Ministry of Health Malaysia. Yang berbahagia, Professor Datuk Dr. Mat Nasir Shamsuddin, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic and International University Putra Malaysia. Yang berbahagia, Professor Datuk Dr. Abdul Jalil Nordin, Dean of Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences, University Putra Malaysia. Yang berusaha, Professor Dr. Zailina Hashim, Chairman of International Conference of Environmental and Occupational Health, ICEOH 2016. Yang berusaha, Associate Professor Dr. Juliana Jalaluddin, Head of Department of Environmental and Occupational Health, University Putra Malaysia. Principal Offices of University Putra Malaysia, Committee Members of Organizer, Distinguished Guests, Participants, Ladies and Gentlemen, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh, and a very good morning, and Salam Satu Malaysia. Welcome to the opening ceremony of International Conference of Environmental and Occupational Health, ICEOH 2016.
Ladies and gentlemen, to begin our program today, we invite Ustaz Dr. Randes Wan Aminul Rashid bin Wan Abdul Hamid from the Islamic Center, University Putra Malaysia, to lead the doa recital.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and very good morning. Ila hadrat Nabi al-Mustafa Muhammadin sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Al-Fatiha. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, Ya Allah, You are glorified. Ya Allah, in praise, Your name is blessed, Your majesty is exalted, and none has the right to worship but You. Indeed, all glory and praise is due to Allah. We glorify and praise Him, and we ask Him for health and forgiveness. In Allah we seek refuge from the evils in ourselves and from our wrongdoings. Allahumma ya Allah ya Rahman, we thank you for making possible for us together here today for this special occasion of International Conference on Environmental and Occupational Health 2016 will be officiated by Yang Berusaha Dr. Chong Chi Kiong. Allahumma ya Rahman ya Rahim, we ask you for the best affairs, the best application, the best success, the best knowledge, the best deed, the best reward, the best life, the best outcome from this conference. Allahumma ya Aziz ya Jabbar, we ask you obligation of your mercy and determination of your forgiveness and the feast of every sin and winning paradise and surviving from hell. Allahumma akhtim lana ya Allah bi husnil khatimah wa la takhtim alina ya Allah bi su'il khatimah. Allahumma yassir lana umurana ma'ar rahati li qulubina wa abdanina was salama wal afiyah fi dinina wa dunyana wa akhiratina. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina azaban nar. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Ustaz. Ladies and gentlemen, to begin our program session today, we now invite Yang Berbahagia Professor Dr. Zailina Hashim, Chairman of ICEOH 2016, to deliver her welcoming address.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera semua. Yang Berbahagia Dr. Chong Chi Kiong, Director of Disease Control Division, Ministry of Health Malaysia, representing Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri Dr. S. Subramaniam, Minister of Health Malaysia. Yang Berbahagia Prof. Datuk Dr. Mat Nasir Shamsuddin, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic and International, University Putra Malaysia. Yang Berbahagia Datuk Dr. Ahmad Kamarul Najib Cik Ibrahim, General Director of Department of Environmental Malaysia, Head of Department Yang Berusaha, Associate Professor Dr. Juliana Jalaluddin, Head of the Department of Environmental and Occupational Health, Faculty of Medicine and Health Science, University Putra Malaysia. Yang Berbahagia Prof. Datuk Dr. Abdul Jalil Nordin, Dean, Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences, University Putra Malaysia. Principal Officers of UPM, University Putra Malaysia, distinguished guests, participants, conference committee members, ladies and gentlemen. As the chairman of the Conference of Environmental and Occupational Health 2016, I'm taking this opportunity to welcome all of you to this conference. For the international participants, especially those who are in Malaysia for the first time, I would like to welcome you to the country. The ICEOH 2016 is actually a platform for the local and international researcher, practitioner, and students of environmental and occupational health to meet, discuss and share their thoughts, exchange knowledge and experiences, planning for future networking group. The team professional and practitioner collaboration, a gateway to sustainable future, is indeed appropriate and timely in view of the current environmental and occupational health issue that threaten human well-being. The organizing committee have received a large number of abstracts for oral and poster presentation, as you can see at the back, many of which were very high quality, and the selection involved some very careful consideration and decision. The organizers are grateful to the author for their enthusiasm and to all the reviewers for the time spent on the evaluation process. I wish to express my heartfelt appreciation to UPM for supporting us in organizing this conference, and to our distinguished speakers, presenters, and participants for your support and participation in the conference. Thank you to all members of the organizing committee and student volunteers for their hard work, effort, and endless support in ensuring the success of the conference. Last but not least, my sincere gratitude to all our co-organizers, sponsors, contributors for your kind support in making the conference a successful one. Thank you to all for being here today. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and salam sejahtera.
Thank you, Yang Berbahagia Prof. Ladies and gentlemen, it is our greatest pleasure to invite Yang Berbahagia Prof. Dato' Dr. Mat Nasir Shamsuddin, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic and International, University Putra Malaysia, to address his speech. Please extend a warm welcome to Yang Berbahagia Prof.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and very good morning. Salam sejahtera. Yang Berbahagia Dr. Chong Chi Kiong, Director of Disease Control Division, Ministry of Health Malaysia. Yang Berbahagia Profesor Datuk Dr. Abdul Jalil Nordin, Dean, Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences. Yang Berbahagia Profesor Dr. Zelina Hashim, Chairman, International Conference of Environmental and Occupational Health, ICEOH 2016. Dr. Juliana Jalaluddin, Head, Department of Environmental and Occupational Health, Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences. Distinguished guests and participants, ladies and gentlemen. Alhamdulillah, syukur kehadirat Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Praise be to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala for giving us the opportunity to gather here this morning for the opening ceremony of the conference. On behalf of UPM, I would like to welcome all the participants and also the international participants. Selamat datang and welcome to our country. We are indeed honored to have you here with us this morning. It gives me a great pleasure to extend to you a very warm welcome from our Datin Paduka Vice Chancellor, who is not able to be here this morning due to a prior commitment. On behalf of the Vice Chancellor, I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate the Department of Environmental and Occupational Health of the faculty and also the Society of Environmental and Occupational Health, as well as the other co-organizers, for the efforts given in organizing the second International Conference on Environmental and Occupational Health here at the Marriott Hotel Putrajaya this morning. I have been informed that this is the second of the conference The first was about 2014, 2 years ago, with more than 350 participants. And I think this year also, we have about the same number. I was informed also that in terms of the safety and also the health, especially in developing countries such as Malaysia, I'm happy to inform that significant progress have been made to continue ensuring the safety, health and well-being of the workers. However, work-related fatalities, disease and cases of injuries are still reported to be occurring, although showing a reduction in trend. The national occupational incident show a reduction from 3.28 incident to 3.1 incidents per 1,000 workers in 2014 compared to the previous year, as reported in the Department of Environmental and Occupational Health. Similarly, the national occupational fatality rate showed a reduction from 4.62 to 4.21 per 1,000 workers in 2014. I am also learning these figures. It's not my field, but I think it's good to learn. As such, to continue protecting the nation workforce, the major role of safety and health professional is not only restricted to the control and management of risk at the workplace to a level that is acceptable by the current standards. Safety and health professionals need to also help workers to make the paradigm shift, in which the concepts of ensuring individual safety and health at the workplace is not only on awareness, but becomes a habitual state of mind. Sharing of knowledge and practice will help the professional and practitioners achieve in its internal role. My background basically is economics, and I'm sure there might be a paper on economics, because my studies indicate that I did a study on the food safety, so the cost of the food safety, actually not compliant with food safety, is very high, because it affects the productivity of the workers and so forth. So similarly, I think we can conduct the economics of the occupational health and also the environment and also occupational health. If the workers are not healthy, a lot of injuries, I'm sure there are a cost to the industry, and the cost of doing business is very, very high. So I'm sure it will affect the competitiveness of the industry. If there is none of the economic study, I also well like to conduct this study when I step down from my post later. As far as the expected outcome of the conference, of course, will increase the awareness of the environmental and occupational health practices among practitioners and researchers, and also highlighting the challenges faced by the players in governmental and private sectors in terms of managing environmental and occupational health. I believe that incredible amount of sharing, learning and leveraging will transpire within these two meaningful days. It is hoped that problem-solving strategies will be further discussed, implemented and coordinated among the professional and practitioners as a result of the sharing of platform at this conference. I wish to take this opportunity to convey my heartfelt appreciation to the excellent collaboration efforts shown by all the contributed by the members of the organizing committee, especially the Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences, the Society of Environmental and Occupational Health, and other co-organizers for the contribution in ensuring the success of this event. With that, I would like to welcome again to all the participants and wish all participants a very productive, fruitful, and a very successful discussion and deliberation. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you very much, Yang Berbahagia Prof. Dato.
Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, it gives us great honor to invite Yang Berbahagia, Dr. Chong Chi Kiong, Director of Disease Control, Ministry of Health Malaysia, to deliver his speech and thereafter to officiate the International Conference on Environmental and Occupational Health, ICEOH 2016, to officiate the Research Center of Excellence, RCOE, for Environmental and Occupational Health, the Asia-Pacific Environmental and Occupational Health Journal, APEOH, and the Environmental and Occupational Health Society. Please welcome Yang Berbahagia Dr. Chong.
Thank you very much, and a very good morning. Yang Bahagia Professor Dr. Dr. Mat Nasir Shamsuddin, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic and International University Putra Malaysia. Yang Bahagia Professor Datuk Dr. Abdul Jalil Nordin, Dean, Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences, University Putra Malaysia. Yang Bahagia Professor Dr. Zalina Hashim, the Chairman of the International Conference of Environmental and Occupational Health, ICEOH 2016. Yang Bahagia Associated Professor Dr. Juliana Jamaluddin, Head of Department of the Environmental and Occupational Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences, Principal Officers of UPM, Distinguished Guests, Participants, Committee Members of Organizers, Ladies and Gentlemen. It is with great optimism of a nation of a better environment and occupational health and safety that I bid you a warm welcome to the International Conference of Environment and Occupational Health, ICEOH 2016. Allow me to congratulate the Environment and Occupational Health Society and the Department of Environment and Occupational Health, University Putra Malaysia, for organizing this very important conference at this crucial junction. And at the same time, let me convey the apologies of the Honourable Minister of Health that he could not be with you here today. And I would like to express a few sentiments of his through the script that I've been given. Environmental and occupational health are two interlinked fields which holds great importance in ensuring that the health of the nation, which are usually mentioned together, each field addressing a variety of issues which contributes towards sustaining good health as well as ensuring a productive nation. In the Southeast Asia and Western Pacific region, we are recognized as among the most rapidly industrializing countries and region all over the world. While this advancement is believed to lead to more development, however, these nations are facing the effects of change, such as the exposure to chemicals, as well as the evolution of diseases and rapid urbanization, all of which comes with a cost to the health of the nation. So the question is, what should we do to minimize this cost of development? Malaysia has been actively participating in many international forums such as the WHO Regional Forum on Environmental and Health, which has brought together the higher level officials and ministers of health, as well as ministers of the environment from many nations such as Brunei, Cambodia, China, Indonesia, Japan, Laos, People's Democratic Republic, Mongolia, Myanmar, Philippines, Republic of Korea, Singapore, Thailand, and Vietnam to address the long-standing and emerging environmental health issues. Malaysia has also pledged to address the environmental issues in the region and has initiated the National Environmental Health Action Plan, also known as NEHAP, which is spearheaded by the Ministry of Health in collaboration with the other agencies such as the Ministry of Natural Resources and Environment, the Ministry of Human Resources, the Ministry of Agriculture, with the primary aim of enhancing environmental and public health. Another important area of concern is occupational health. This field has been progressing due to the rapid industrialization of the country and the region. The Occupational Safety and Health Act strengthened the need and the direction of occupational health in our country. As Malaysia goes towards the vision of being a developed nation, so should the activities that facilitates in the achievement of occupational health and involve in the collaboration between doctors and engineers and the other industries. And thus, it is important to realize that this joint partnership can ensure the success of occupational health and safety of the nation. The important areas that need to be addressed in occupational health are funding, human resources, equipment, and technology. A lack of commitment in these areas can inhibit the progress of occupational health. Time and again, we see a trade-off, and this time it is between the workers' health and versus the production of the industry. Malaysia is party to the WHO Global Plan of Action on Workers' Health and is initiating many programs led by the Department of Occupational Health and led by the Department of Occupational Safety and Health, together with the Social Security Organization, as well as the Ministry of Health, among other stakeholders. The Environment and Occupational Health Society was first registered in February 2015. By far, this is the first national association comprising of dedicated environmental and occupational health practitioners, both professional, research, and students, who has passion towards the field of environmental and occupational health. Even though the society is still in its infancy, it has, however, committed itself to the promotion of health and safe living and working environment, and also the commitment to our community. For example, with the collaboration of visionary leaders, the ICEOH 2016 is held today with the collaboration between the Environment and Occupational Health Society and the Department of Environmental and Occupational Health, University Putra Malaysia. This is among the initiatives that the organizing committee takes to promote the environmental and occupational health disciplines to the community through the activities of research, training, consultation, and publication, and becoming the platform for bridging environmental and occupational health professionals with industries and the community through national and international networks. I'm pleased also to note that the continuous effort from the Department of Environmental and Occupational Health, UPM, with their latest effort to create its own journal publication known as the Asia Pacific Environmental and Occupational Health Journal, or APEOHJ, in October 2015. Ladies and gentlemen, we are committed to the fact that this is a continuous commitment and dedicated action that one should make to tackle the interlinked health and environmental challenges that we are faced with today. It is of crucial importance to discover new knowledge and enhance awareness among the ministries of health and also the ministries of environment to the mutual relevance and benefit of each other, policies, strategies, and programs. With this, allow me to commend the complement steps taken by members of the Department of Environment and Occupational Health, UPM, for their Research Centers of Excellence, Pusat Kecemerlangan Penyelidikan Kesihatan, Perkesitan dan Pekerjaan, established in December 2015. With this new formation of the new center, they shall be able to carry out a multifaceted and coordinated approach, such as research and knowledge production, education and training, information brokerage, networking, and e-service rendering. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that among many other things, this conference will help illustrate the linkage that exists between the community's environmental health and other issues that have been the hallmark of the country's health authority. This conference holds a lot of meaningful aspirations and hopes for Malaysia and to our neighbouring countries. We therefore await the results of the conference and the steps that you propose to take, and I wish you success in your deliberations. With that, I take great pleasure to inaugurate the Environmental and Occupational Health Society, the Asia Pacific Environmental and Occupational Health Journal, APEOHJ, and the Research Centers of Excellence in Environmental and Occupational Health. Allow me now to declare the International Conference of Environmental and Occupational Health, ICEOH 2016, officially open. Wishing you every success in your endeavors. Thank you.
With that, we would like to invite Yang Berbahagia, Professor Datuk Dr. Mat Nasir Shamsuddin, to deliver a token of appreciation to Yang Berbahagia Dr. Chong Chi Kiong. Thank you, Yang Berbahagia Dr. Chong Chi Kiong, and Yang Berbahagia Professor Datuk Dr. Mat Nasir Shamsuddin.
The multimedia presentation.
and gentlemen, again, please give a big round of applause to the organizing committee of ICEOH 2016 for an incredible effort on making this conference, RCOE, Journal and Society, a reality. With the souvenirs and multimedia presentation, the opening ceremony of International Conference on Environmental and Occupational Health 2016 has come to the end. The organizing committee wish to thank everyone who has been involved in ensuring the success of this ceremony. Have a pleasant and fruitful conference.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now proceed with the photography session. Can we humbly request the VIPs to remain at their seat, and participants, can you ever so kindly move towards the center of the ballroom? Thank you very, very much. Participants on my left and right, can you move to the center of the ballroom, please? Thank you. Participants, can you please? We would like to have a photography session. Thank you very much.
Photographers, kindly request all the participants to be in the center at the back of the VIP seats so that all of you will be seen in the picture. Thank you. Ever so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, light refreshments are served at the foyer. Everyone is invited to enjoy some coffee and tea. To all the other participants, please be reminded that the next session will commence at about 10:15 a.m. With that, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good day. Thank you very much.
Have a pleasant day, everyone. Thank you.